For this sub 17 example, I'm running it on Vasa, Tekton, Tightrope, Vespula, and Crabs. This is the core gear I would recommend for learning this layout, filling the empty spaces with brews and restores if you need. If you're good at minimizing damage at Olm, you can sub brews out for extra gear. In order of usefulness, I would start by adding the Inquisitor's Mace. This is higher DPS than Lance on the Vasa Crystal, and if you only hit one hammer at Tekton, it'll be higher DPS than the Scythe there also. Ring of Recoil can be extra damage reflected back to Vasa for the initial hit, and can be dropped afterwards to free up an inventory slot. Picasians also offer a tiny DPS gain, although this will change to the Missouri Helm when that gets released. Standard pre-pot with Vengeance, summon Mage Thrall and send Vasa. You can skip Vasa pots if you don't have room. In this run, I'm picking them up for the content. We eat up here because we need to overload after Tekton and be above 23 HP for the rope skip. You can drop the super combat after repotting. Sip and drop the prayer enhance, take an overload and the restore. Overload while running to tightrope and keep stamina high. I have a guide on rope skipping if you don't already know how to do this. Normal 5 tick Vespula, you might have to 6 tick near the end of the fire if your hits aren't great. Normal CM crabs, first magenta, then yellow, black, and then cyan. While running to Olm, check Lance is on Crush, Scythe is on Slash, and Sang is on Accurate. This is a pretty below average Olm, my mage hits were pretty bad throughout. I timestamped each phase though if there's something in particular you want to watch. If you made it this far, comment, "Oh my god, purple," to bait others to watch. Like and subscribe.